Mid-South was the backdrop to many crucial moments in the civil rights movement. Now, a segregation lawsuit filed way back then is only now being resolved, and it will likely affect where thousands of kids go to school. WREG's Natasha Chen is here to explain how the almost 50-year-old lawsuit and controversy is now taking shape. Natasha, what took so long?
Well, the suit was actually filed in 1965 by a woman living in Somerville, and now in 2012, we're about to see lots of changes to where the students go to school. Over the years, there were other court orders, but very little changed. Now there's a joint agreement by everyone involved.
Fayette County schools could look very different in about 2 years.
Well, we all be scared about change, but you have to make a change. You have to step forward.
Almost 50 years since a segregation lawsuit was filed, the Fayette County Board of Education and the NAACP now agree on a plan in federal court. The plan is to shut down Somerville Elementary, which is largely white, and Jefferson Elementary, largely black, and build one new school. On a basic level, this Jefferson Elementary mom is excited about a new building for her kids. Plus,
they get to meet different kids and, you know, like white and black. Everybody get together and just be as one, you know. I think that would be real nice.
After rezoning, people in the area of the new school, Oakland Elementary and Southwest Elementary, will get to state their preferred school. And the district will try to match that preference with creating the most diverse student bodies. Northwest Elementary, which is predominantly black, will become a magnet school, specializing in one subject designed to attract students from all over the county. Some parents may be hesitant. Others may wonder why the change happened so slowly. But one thing is certain.
Everybody have to pull together to get something done. Just one or two people can't do it.
Now, I tried reaching out to the Fayette County Superintendent, the school board chairman, and one of the elementary school PTOs, but none of them got back to me for this story. Reporting live, Natasha Chen, WREG News Channel 3.